In this lecture, we are going to solve question based on state transition testing. So let's have a look into the question. How many test cases are required to cover 100% zero switch coverage respectively from X2? So here we have different states or nodes, X1, X2, X3, X4 and X5. But in question, they are specifically talking about X2, which is over here. And the options given are 4, 1, 3 and 2. So before we proceed further, what we need to know is the meaning of 100% zero switch. So let's have a quick revision on it. Achieving 100% zero switch coverage requires that every valid sequence of one successive transition has been tested at least once. So we have to test the successive transition from the given node. Let's see how to do that. So this is the question, and in the question they were talking about X. So we will have this table, and from X2 we will see that how many successive nodes are going outside. So from X2, if you see, this is one successive node, which is B. So B is going to be our one test case. And then from X2, the other transition is C. So this is the next transition. So the next one is C. If you see X2, there are no more outgoing transitions. Incoming are there, but we have to test the outgoing transitions in order to cover zero switch. And that is the reason our answer is going to be, we need two test cases to cover 100% zero switch. So out of this option, option D is going to be our answer. Thank you for listening to me.